professional scrum trainer Ryan Ripley, and I'm a professional scrum trainer Todd Miller. So we've just completed the Professional Scrum Trainer 2 course, the Advanced Scrum Master Class from scrum.org. We've been asked to talk a little bit about the Professional Scrum Master, and since that's what this whole course is about, we thought it'd be a great time to talk through that.
Yeah, and so when we think of the Professional Scrum Master, and the way we think everybody should be the Professional Scrum Master, is that in being in alignment with empiricism and the pillars of empiricism, but not only that, but being in alignment with the Scrum values. And so when we say the pillars of empiricism, we're talking about inspection, adaptation, and transparency.
And when we talk about the Scrum values, what we're really talking about is focus, openness, commitment, courage, and respect. These things, the principles and the values, they come together and they are infused into the Scrum Master. We lead as a servant leader our Scrum teams with the values and principles. They're non-negotiable. Otherwise, we end up with mechanical Scrum, zombie Scrum, bad Scrum, whatever you want to call it. So a professional Scrum Master leads first and foremost with the principles, transparency, inspection, adaptation, rooted in trust, and also the Scrum values, focus, openness, commitment, courage, and respect.
Yeah, and I noticed there you said serves the Scrum team. So let's talk about that a little bit, how the Scrum Master and who the Scrum Master serves. So first, the Scrum Master serves the development team. When we talk about serving the development team, we talk about servant leadership, right? And so servant leadership is really coming to understand and know and feel good about other people's accomplishments and helping them along the way, right? So a Scrum Master serves the development team, and a lot of what we've explored over the past 2 days is that it's not servant, it's servant leader, right?
Right, big difference.
Yeah. And so that's how we serve the development team. There's a lot of specifics we could get into.
Let's do a few, right?
Yeah.
So I think a lot of ways that we show up sometimes as Scrum Masters could be as an admin. Right, we manage the ticketing system, we manage the user stories, we scribe down notes, we order the pizza, we bring the coffee.
Yeah.
That's not really a servant leader or a professional Scrum Master.
That's a servant.
That's a servant.
Right. So in the context we're talking about being a professional Scrum Master, you might actually serve a development team by being invisibly present.
Yeah.
Right? You might facilitate events for them, you might facilitate a conversation between them and the greater organization. You remove impediments. Impediments they can't remove on their own, right? That's not, we need more caffeine, right?
Yeah.
It's impediments they can't remove on their own.
But often what you'll find is you're in a different type of stance. You could be in a facilitation stance, like Todd mentioned,
yes.
A coaching stance, a mentorship stance. Sometimes developers will need mentorship on excellent technical practices, which is a huge part of professional Scrum, right? So we're really there more as that servant leader and not the servant, as Todd mentioned.
Yes.
I think another interesting aspect of the professional Scrum Master is that our focus is not just on the development team.
Correct.
I think far too often Scrum Masters put a lot of focus directly on the development team, and they don't realize that there are two other levels of service, one of them being to the product owner.
Yeah, and so let's talk about a little about how a Scrum Master serves the product owner.
Yeah.
And one thing that we have been having a large conversation about is this concept behind a lonely product owner, right?
Right.
Product owners need help with facilitation too. Right? And sometimes product owners need help with coaching. And sometimes you can take the stance of a teacher, teaching the product owner the importance of empiricism and inspection, adaptation, and transparency from their vantage point. Right? We really want a transparent product backlog. Right? We want to inspect and we want to adapt based off of a sprint review.
Absolutely.
And so there's a lot that a Scrum Master can do to serve a product owner, and they really should be partners in making this all work.
Yeah, I think partnership is the big term here, right? So as a Scrum Master, we're walking alongside the product owner. We're making this a less lonely experience. Consider the product owner, have a little empathy for that role for a second. They're getting a lot of pressure from stakeholders, customers, executives. There's a lot of pressure coming up from the development team about what is and isn't possible. There's a lot of voices and a lot of competing thoughts going on. Our role can simply be to be a sounding board, to help them sort through the complexity that product development really is.
Yeah, I absolutely agree.
But the other service level we need to talk about is to the wider organization, right? So often that's a big scary thing, that's something that Scrum Masters can often shy away from. We need to be bold here. We need to realize that there are systems of work at play well outside of our Scrum team that if we're not influencing and helping bring into an Agile or Scrum space, we're not really serving our teams well at all either.
Yeah, and if I may give a really good concrete example, at least I think it's a good concrete
example. Please, let's try it.
Yeah, so let's talk about the budgeting aspects of the organization. So when we talk about the budgeting aspects of the organization and how we might serve the greater organization, a lot of our organizations are really based off of waterfall thinking when it comes comes to budgeting.
Annual budgeting.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
One decision at one time, and then that's for the rest of the year.
Yes, and in order to budget this product development effort that we want, we need to create these rules about the certainty of the outcome.
Right.
And so what's the comfortable thing for us to do is to say those rules are the requirements that we're going to gather beforehand. Yeah. Otherwise, we're not going to budget this project. So as a Scrum Master, as a professional Scrum Master, that might be a really interesting area for you to explore in your organization.
And so how do you do that, right? And a lot of it comes down to making things visible. How do we make progress visible? How do we make impediments visible? How do we show the organization in a respectful, focused way, there's the values coming in, that some of the things going on in the wider company is preventing the Scrum team from delivering? Yeah. I think that's a very powerful message and part of being a professional Scrum Master. We're working in all three areas that not only create balance, but also transparency and openness so that we can learn all how to work together and ultimately ship a done, potentially releasable product increment.
Absolutely, 100%. And in service to the development team, in service to the product owner, in service to the greater organization, there's one thing that we fall back on, right? We fall back on the principles and values of Scrum.
Always.
Yeah. Inspection, adaptation, and transparency, and then the five values of Scrum.
And then, you know, something that we talk about often is the Scrum Guide is 19 pages of great insight and wisdom about developing products in a complex world. But there's a lot of gray area in between the lines. There's situations that are not covered by the Scrum Guide. As a Scrum Master, we fall back on those values and principles, as Todd said, to help us navigate the complexity of using Scrum and of being a Scrum Master in these complex environments and organizations. I think the last thing to say about this, some tips and tricks to really internalize the Scrum values and principles so that you can take that next step to becoming the professional Scrum Master that you know you can be. Take some time and really internalize the Scrum values. Think about focus, openness, commitment, courage, and respect. And journal. Take 10 minutes each day and write about how you leverage those values in your work. Now, if you find out that you didn't use those values in your work that day, take that time to plan for tomorrow. How do you intend to show up modeling and behaving in ways that are in alignment with those values? I think that's one really good tip.
Yeah, and I think to build on that too, another tip that we may give is the three pillars of empiricism and everything that you're doing, right? Scrum is just a framework, right? And so many times we find that so many complementary practices are added to it and that we built Scrum into this big thing, right? So I think it's really good and important to look at the effects on things that you're doing inside of Scrum and the effects that might have on inspection, adaptation, and transparency.
Yeah, really continually inspecting those practices, like Todd said. Yeah. And actually, when you're reading through the Scrum Guide, and I hope you're doing that often, right? As professional Scrum trainers, we visit the Scrum Guide often. I think you as a professional Scrum Master could do that as well. Think about how empiricism and the Scrum values are at play in every Scrum event, and in every artifact, and in every role. As you work through that gradually, I think your understanding of the Scrum values, your ability to model them and live them, will be enhanced.
Yeah, and you know, my final thought is we are working in the complex domain of software development.
Yep.
Where more is unknown than known.
Totally.
I think it's up to us to really bring comfort in the complex domain, or uncomfort, maybe, as a professional Scrum Master.
Sure.
But I think we need to bring awareness to the complex domain, where more is unknown than known. We can't just create rules and follow them and expect an expected outcome. That would be remiss, and it would be pointing towards the fact that we think we're in the simple domain when we're in the complex domain.
So we hope you enjoyed this video. We hope we've given you a peek into what the professional Scrum Master, what that looks like.
Yes.
Remember the principles, remember the values. There's a lot of great articles on scrum.org, so check out the blogs and the other videos out there. Check out the forums. The forum is a great location. Todd and I are out there. If you have any questions, post a question to the forums. Find us on Twitter or LinkedIn. We love talking about this stuff. But we hope we've helped you take that next step down your path of being a professional Scrum Master.